of fact, it's a very big day indeed tomorrow, because we've got 6 different matches and we've got...
Well, that's not one of Steve's better breaks, and Fieldcliff will be taking this red on. Just has to hold the white there because the black is available into the opposite corner. Cliff now taking the red to the right 16. Of the black, which will open up the path again for the black into both corner pockets. Cliff just leaving an angle on the black there so that he can come up. Still a loose red there to the right of the pike. Or he could even screw around the angles for the other red.
32.
We must have spotted a plant because he could have played for the red to the right of the pink there, so he has got a plant on into this corner pocket.
Forty-eight.
And this time I don't think he's come quite high enough to run through for the black. So we'll be splitting the reds here and trying to run through the reds. And now he's given himself an excellent chance of clinching this frame at this one visit. And by the look on Cliff's face, I think he can pop this red into the corner. I think Cliff got a kick on the black there. It certainly seemed to come off at a very funny angle.
Mark, please.
And of course he's given Steve a chance here. Still enough points on the table. And Steve certainly got straighter than he would have liked on this black.
So far, we've had 11 reds potted and only blacks, but Steve now taking a pink.
Fifteen. 16.
And if Steve can pinch this frame here, it would hurt Cliff.
23.
Now this red could be Cliff's saviour. Steve has to catch this pink right to split them.
And it's absolutely perfect. Points in it, and the six colors to go.
45.
This frame in complete contrast to the last.
54.
Steve's overrun a little there. Not the best of shots. We'll have to now go in and out of ball to come back for the black.
65.
It's all square. 65 points each. An amazing frame of snooker. Just two visits to the table.
10 to win. Yes, and Steve Davis wanted that one, didn't he?
One.
8. No. 14. Fifteen. 22. 23.
And now that removing that red opens those three into this opposite corner pocket. So plenty of loose reds here for Steve to go at.
30. Thirty-six. 37. 42. 43. 49.
So Cliff's missed black, proving very costly. He sat there contemplating the mistake. 50. The break reaches 50.
57.
So just the red and the blue to put this frame safe. 58.
63.
55 points ahead, and only 51 points left. But Steve, yet to finish.
64.
Steve has had a lot of breaks in this second semi-final, but 71. This is his highest so far.
72. 79. 80. 85. 87. 90.
So he now records the highest in this semi-final.
94.
He's already had four snooker hundreds in these championships and holds the highest break of the championship, claiming £7,000 at the moment with a break of 134. 100% clearance then by the former world snooker champion Steve Davis, the 16th century of the championships, a break of 112, and they're all square, 10 frames each.
Stage that match is at, it'll be concluded tonight, and when snooker returns to your screens...
...by Steve Davis, the top break of 134, that's £7,000 if he's still there at the end of the championship. Rather interesting that one name missing is Cliff Thorburn, the master break maker, the 147 man here, yet to get a century. Let's see what the next frame of this intriguing semi-final against Steve Davis holds in store for the Canadian. Then frame 21, Thorburn's at the table, he's a point ahead and scheming.
Yes, that's a great shot from Cliff Thorburn. Steve will have to be very careful here.
Well, this looks dangerous. He's trying to rest into those four reds near the pink spot there. Now, has he left this red into the middle? And off Cliff's reactions, I would say it's certainly possible.
He's looking to see if the black will go. And now to reap the rewards of his good snooker.
Nine.
Well, he didn't intend kissing the black, wanted to pass it to get the cue ball to the right-hand side of it.
So both players had a chance this game. And Cliff now going off the blue to try and get back again between that yellow, green and brown.
Looks as though he took notice of you, John.
Stroke, four,
a different escape route, but he's got them pretty safe.
I think Cliff's got a nice angle on this red, though, to probably drop the white back down behind those three bolt colours. This time made a mistake and a little too hard, and I think Steve's got a not too difficult red now into the centre pocket.
Sending the red to the cleaners.
One.
has the black.
One, Steve Gibbs.
And my word, the tension is rising very high there this morning.
And this is certainly the best chance in this frame. Made it a little more difficult here. We'll need the... Well, he's trying to reach over. I would have thought he'd need the long tattle, but has to screw this black back.
Going for the furniture to save the overreaching.
Yes, has to be pretty accurate here. There's just the two reds. We'll go into the left-hand corner pocket.
Cliff, as you see, 21 points ahead. Still six reds to go there.
Nine.
And that's a good shot from Cliff. Brought the other red down, so it just needs to pot the black and bounce off the back cushion for the red into the right-hand corner. Making sure he's got an angle on the black there, just to stun up now for the two reds will go into the right and centre pocket. Would like to have been straighter on this red, so that he could have screwed direct for the black.
25.
Cliff just looking at the scoreboard there, which tells him he's 38 in front. So doesn't need to bother with those two reds near the pink spot. Just the pink and one more red would leave Steve needing snookers.
Very quick to look 31. At referee Len Genley. The pink has gone on his spot. I think Cliff felt that it wouldn't go.
That's the one that Cliff wanted to see in. Steve now needing snookers. So that red's certainly clinching this frame and will make Cliff feel a lot better, because just with one frame to go this session, he now knows he goes into the evening session at least all square.
Steve waves his hand. He concedes that 21st frame.
Thorburn just popping out there. Don't forget, this is the third time they've met in the World Championship at the Crucible, and the 81 semi-final when Davis won was really an excellent match. So's this one. Last frame of the session. Davis to break.
Cliff looks as though he's having a go at this one, so we'll be trying to force this one in, I would think, and taking the red back down for the blue or one of the bolt colours.
You're quite right, Johnny. He has taken the red down to the blue.
And it looks as though Steve might be refusing this black. Taking no chances.
Steve Davis, one.
Well, Steve playing very cagey in this 22nd frame.
This time he's got the snooker, so Cliff will be coming off the side cushion into the reds just to the left of the pink.
Not very happy about that. He's left a red into the top pocket if Steve wants it.
Steve won't be happy with that either.
One.
There was a path there to get through down for the black into the centre. So Steve would deem that a chance missed.
Thank you.
He's found the pocket.
Four. Steve Divis.
Steve wanting this frame to make the match all square at 11 frames each. He started this session one frame up.
Not hard enough there. I think this red will pass the black, but would like to have been a lot straighter. Now has to screw down the table off it. There is a loose red to the left of the pack here, but Steve, if he wanted, could split the pack. Perfect angle on the green. And by the look on his face, he can't get through to the red into the right-hand corner pocket, and that's very unfortunate. And what a difference that fraction of an inch could make to this frame.
It appears that both those reds are covered by the green. attempting to cut this one back. Cue ball running too strong.
What? Thorburn.
What?
And of course, Cliff has left Steve a chance of just rolling the red past the blue and leaving the white there, but a very dangerous shot. Should the white turn at all, could stick Cliff in with an easy chance. Appears that what Steve's trying.
And he has left it.
So the first real chance Cliff's had for this, in this frame. And looks to have the perfect angle there, just a screw back for the red just above into the same pocket. And this is an excellent opportunity for Cliff. We'll eventually have to split those five reds around the pink spot, but won't be too difficult. May even do it here.
He didn't want that.
No, he's playing on the third red in there and just got too much bottom on the ball. But still has a choice of reds into either middle pocket, I think.
in here. Can't get a firm bridge.
Well, this could be the big shot of this frame.
Yes, I just wonder what his thoughts are right now. Steve's messed it up. Thorburn, looking very seriously, straight away.
Well, I think Steve may be able to get through to the pink.
Steve recovers then.
Thirteen. Fourteen.
Again, it's not worked out.
21.
No, he was trying to slide by those two reds for the red into this right-hand corner pocket. So both players making mistakes this game, of course. All the time, the pressure out there must be building up.
Steve Davis, 21.
Now, those last four reds are perfectly placed. A mistake now could be fatal.
Thank you.
Putting the green will bring the cue ball back up for the last three reds. This really is a battle of the giants. He started off one frame down. One more session to go of nine frames. This the last frame of the morning session.
That's not a good shot from Steve. Just the green available.
Eight.
Of course, Steve not worried about the size of the colour, just wants to get rid of the two reds.
Nine.
Looking for the yellow there, and I don't think he's got it. Playing this with a lot of right hand side to swerve it round the pink.
And this red, the ball he wants to put the frame beyond Cliff Thorburn. He wants two snookers. And a very cautious shot from Steve there, playing a snooker on this yellow.
Oops.
And so Cliff Thorburn says, well, that's enough for this morning. He started off one frame down and finishes all square, 11 frames each.
Which means when they change into the dinner jackets and the bow ties here, there'll be nine to play, and both men need five frames to reach this year's final. It looks like being a big Saturday night here at the Crucible, the semi-final action you can watch in two more programmes this evening here on BBC Two. But we haven't finished this. He's got to play tomorrow. We're going to show you now what's happening in this match. 11 all, as we said. Let's join the first frame of tonight. Thorburn has potted the first red. Davis has got a red and a yellow, but with 4 points from a foul, Davis leads 7-1. Thorburn back at the table, your commentators John Virgo and Clive Everton.
stroke. 4, Steve Davis.
Instead of which, the first chance falls to Davis. From just inside the yellow spot, I think he can get the potting angle on the red nearest the right corner pocket. Angle though, it looks a bit tighter.
Yes, I think he can get through to pot it, but he would like to be just running through on the red and coming round the back of the black. But the angle he's got to play it firm to stun the white off the cushion. That makes the pot more difficult.
So after the sparring, this is where the punching begins.
Nineteen. Ready? 26. 27. Thirty-five.
Not as good as it would have been had he finished straighter on the red immediately behind the black. Forty-nine.
Now 66 points to lead, so just one more red.
56.
And very impressive start this from Steve. Just one real chance, and he certainly made Cliff pay for it.
57. Seventy. 71. 78.
And with that break of 79, Steve Davis regains the lead.
Yes, 12-11, not unnaturally, this being the first frame of the night, Thorburn potted all the remaining balls, but the frame went to Davis. Now, here in the next, Davis has got the lead, 21 points to nil, but Thorburn has made a mistake, and he's let Davis in, and the choices here, well, there must be a handful of them. All Davis has got to do is to choose one, and hope it's the right one. Which one do you try and pot out of that lot?
Well, it was very, very difficult indeed for Davis to find a path back to Bourke there. So tight has been the safety that it's 12 minutes since a ball's been potted. Chances coming so rarely, you have to make what few you have tell.
Team. 15.
Well, that's a nice shot by Cliff. The red over the left-hand centre pocket. Cliff 22. Will want to leave that red for the last possible moment. That is always a standby should he run out of position on the other reds. So there's no way he'll be wanting to move that.
Forty-seven.
Well, after this black, Cliff just need another three reds and colours to make the frame safe. And those three reds he needs are in the open.
16.
61.
40 points the lead, so after this black, just one more red. And when you see both players playing like this, given the slightest opportunity, you can understand why 68. The safety play has got to be of such a high standard.
Yes, after 20 minutes safety play in the first frame, Davis's break of 79 was decisive. We had 12 minutes of safety before this break, and similarly, it looks like being decisive. Two frames combining marvellous safety play and deadly break making. Davis won the first, Thorburn the second, 12-all.
Which means in this absorbing semi-final there are 7 frames left to play and both men need 4 to go into the final. We've ordered up the late night coffee. I think it could be a late Saturday night. See you later, the match to a finish. Johnson in the 2-day final. Here's the next they play, frame 25. There's Thorburn. 2-0 up. John Virgo and Clive Everton will commentate.
Well, that wasn't how he intended to play safe. He Certainly didn't mean to play cushion first. Yes, this is a really nasty one. The cue ball's so close to the balk cushion and also so close to the green that it's very difficult. It's very difficult for him to get any angle to get up the table, and certainly no angle to hopefully strike the reds a glancing blow and get back to balk. So he's really in dire trouble.
Yes, and Cliff just asked referee Len Ganley how much time did he have. There isn't any time limit, but it's certainly going to take a while to work this one out. Normally in these situations, you look at the red you'd like to hit. The snooker's so tight, it's a case of which red you can hit.
One possibility is using the jaws of one of the balk pockets. But that's generally a last resort.
Six. Seven. Twelve.
Well, Davis has just gone back to his chair to give his cue a wipe and perhaps also to refocus his concentration. Maybe he just lost his train of thought, pondering the various possibilities here. So the red nearest the pink won't go.
Yes, and I think he played on the red nearest the pink. So just having a concentration problem at the moment, I suggest. And that's different from the first two frames. Each time one of the, either of the players has got a chance, they've won the frame.
Yes. 79 by break by Davis in the first frame, a 104 by Thorburn in the second.
Well, Cliff has purposely played for the ping into the left-hand centre pocket. But he certainly thought it'd be easier than this.
Cliff Thorburn, 5, Steve Davis.
Very unlucky indeed to knock the yellow in. As long as the cue ball remained on the table, he was at least going to have a shot at his next red.
Six.
7. Thirteen. 14.25. 26.
Davis played there to disturb the red from the black, but knowing that if he shaved by it, he was always going to be on the blue.
...38 points to lead, so still needs one of these reds. Of course, if they got that cannon, it made a lot easier for him. It's going to take a good shot now to get position off this blue.
One more red would put him 44 in front with only 43 on the table.
Thank you.
32, Steve Gibbs.
And that proved to be enough for Davis to go ahead again, 13-12. Well, frame 26, very cagey all the way, to Davis leading at 45 points to 28. Just one red left, maximum distance, as you can see, from the cue ball. And then between the cue ball and the cushion up there, there's the green. And Davis has got to bridge over that.
So, about half a dozen shots ago, Steve Davis was denied a winning chance. He only needed red, black, yellow. Denied that winning chance by a fortunate run of the balls for the Canadian.
One.
Anywhere but there. So the black which saved him those half dozen shots ago is now not available.
Well, if Steve is going this way, I suggest he's trying to hit it off three cushions. Top side and balk cushions. Well, he played the pot.
Well, even he's not that good. But it was a good hit. The idea here is to screw back from the green just enough to leave the angle on the brown to either knock the blue out or drop behind it.
Thorburn, two.
this frame already in play 50 minutes, the longest of the match. We're only 7 minutes away now from 2.5 hours for four frames this evening. But what a titanic battle this has been. restrained buzz of anticipation goes round the auditorium, particularly from those who know that Davis now needs only green and brown in this frame. And 26 in front with only 13 on the table is surely enough to give Davis 14-12.
Absolutely right. So five to play. Davis needs two of them. Thorburn needs all but one. Now take a look at the start of frame 27. Thorburn's at the table. He's got 4 points, but that's on a foul by Davis, so all the balls are still there. And Thorburn seems to be eyeing up a double. That seems to be the target. So a double on, according to the Canadian, and John Spencer and Ted Lowe are watching the attempt.
I think Cliff was playing a double, but not that way. He's taking this black on. It's a brave shot at this stage of the match. Not an easy pot, this. And that's an excellent pot from Cliff there.
Well, our camera showed you that that red was into the top of the jaws of the pocket, never quite there, but it's certainly done some damage.
One.
8. Nine. 16. Seventeen.
And Steve won't want to make any mistakes here. Obviously sense this is his chance.
Thirty. 31.
Well, 36. Steve went into the reds there, knowing he'd be left this red into the centre. But got rather awkward queuing.
Davis, 42.
break of 42 then, and Steve looking for two frames to make his fifth final in 6 years. He's got the black tucked up with that last shot. Bad one from Cliff.
One, Cliff Thorburn.
Yes, and that miss from Cliff can only give Steve added confidence.
One.
That was an excellent shot there from Steve. Just disturbed the black. And the black won't spot now, so down on the blue spot.
15.
And now enough loose reds at this top end of the table for Steve to clinch this frame at this visit.
15. Steve Gibbs. Thank you, gentlemen. One.
That one's not too good for his colour.
And all he can do is try the snooker behind the blue.
Thank you. Foul stroke. Four, Cliff Thorburn.
And Cliff doesn't fancy the position left after the foul. The difference, and 59 points on the table. A tremendous battle of wits between these two great stars.
So, just one more red required now by Steve to leave Cliff needing snookers.
Ten.
14.
Well, nerves of steel and very accurate putting from this former world champion. Three times he's taken the title in the last 5 years.
18.
Cliff now trailing by three frames.
27.
A battle 32. Extraordinaire then between these two. And Steve Davis now putting one more frame on the scoreboard to lead 15 frames to 12.
28.
And requiring just one more frame to get himself into the final for a fifth time in 6 years.
Well, quite understandably, at the start of the next frame, that's frame 28 out of the maximum 31, no player was prepared to give anything away. It got even more cagey, and then for the second time in this year's championship, we had one of these situations. The cue ball tucked in there amongst the reds. It had been in and out two or three times. The players had sort of just sort of been tickling it. And then this time, the players agreed they were going to get absolutely nowhere. So they said to referee Len Gurney, come on, let's stop this. We're quite happy for the balls to be racked up. We'll start it over again. A stalemate. So Len Ganley cleared the balls, racked them all up, and they started frame 28 again. Davis got the best start. He had a break of 44. Then he put down another red. So Cliff Thorburn now finds himself 45 points to nil down. But there are plenty there for the taking on the table.
John, I can't help thinking that's another mistake.
Yes, he's quite a long way off with that one. Given Steve two chances, red into this corner pocket or red into the centre pocket. And if Steve gets this and gets on the black, I think that is the end of the match.
Bradford's Joe Johnson waits in the final for the winner of this semi-final. Canadian former world champion Cliff Thorburn putting up a terrific battle here and perhaps at the moment looking a trifle sad.
but he's had his joyous moments during this championship with the birth of his second son.
Well, Steve, looking round here, but of course just needs this red, followed by the black, to leave Cliff needing snookers.
17. 24.28. 29.
Every ball still very important to the 28-year-old Londoner, Steve Davis.
37.
Determined, relentless. But he's also a happy boy. He knows now that he's got himself to the final.
43.
Of the 1986 World Championship.
44.
This is a terrific performance by Steve Davis.
51.
He's been pressed to the hilt by the Canadian throughout these 27, 28 frames.
52.
Cliff has fought every inch of the way.
57.
The complete young master
59.
Of snooker.
62. 66. 71.
So it's just the pink and black to go. The break becomes 84. And Steve Davis defeats Cliff Thorburn 16 frames to 12 and goes into the final for the fifth time in 6 years.
So there we have it, all spelt out for us. 35 frame final over 2 days, 2 days of snooker for the 1986 Embassy World title. The winner will take home £70,000. The runner-up, quite a nice little check for £42,000. A final of contrast, we've got the big outsider versus the favourite, and an outsider who until this year had never won a match here in the Crucible. Joe, you must be fed up with being called the new man of snooker after all you've done before the Crucible, but this is the new image of snooker.
What do you think of the shirt, David?
I think that's wonderful. You're going to tell me where it was made, aren't you?
Made in Japan.
Nothing to do with the band.
No.
Wonderful day for you.
Terrific. Absolutely terrific.
How did it go for you out there? Obviously well, from where we were watching it.
Well, I was a lot more nervous today than what I have been. Because really? I think that the shoe was on the other foot today. Yeah. I'd been the underdog all the way, but at 14-8, I was expected to win. And I felt very nervous today.
Did you get a little twitch out there? Didn't seem to.
Well, I felt it.
Really?
I really felt it, yeah. It was tough snooker for me. I don't know what it looked like on television, but for me, it was tough.
You were smiling a lot. That makes a change.
Yeah, everybody seems to have a go at me for that.
What's the big difference this year, then? I mean, you've got over the nerves, and suddenly you're playing the snooker that a lot of people know you can play.
Well, I wish somebody could tell me, and then I could use it again. I don't know what's happened this year. Just don't know.
What about the family? You've got a big family, haven't you?
Got six kids, yeah. Yeah, they're all watching today.
Are they?
Yeah, hi, kids.
They're not here?
No. We couldn't get the tickets, David. You know what it's like here.
Are they going to bring them for the final?
No, I don't think so. Might bring one or two. It depends. We haven't got a big enough car to bring all the lot. We'll just take them out two at a time.
Well, by the look of the dress, you're obviously totally relaxed now. What are you going to do between now and the final?
I think I'll just call into the local tonight and drink a couple of shandies and relax. Relax till tomorrow.
Because you live not far from here, you can go home.
25 minutes away. Yeah. 25 minutes.
Well, they'll be waiting for you back there, without any doubt at all.
I've got so many people to thank, David, it's untrue. Is it all right if I thank a few people?
Go on.
Yeah, I'd like to thank my mum and dad, because they started me off when they had a liberal club when I was 16. And I wish I could thank my father-in-law who died last year. He always said I could do it, and he's not here to see it. And I'd like to thank my wife. Yeah, there's so many people I'd like to thank, and everybody's here been terrific to me.
Well, as we talk, there's only two people that stand between you and the championship of the world, Mr. Davis or Mr. Thorburn.
Two players, eh? Two players. Which one would I want? That's the next question. I don't want either. Cliff's beat me three times this season, and I've never played Steve as a professional, although we did play a lot as amateurs. Played a lot of times together, and it was always tough snooker, didn't it? I don't relish the prospect of meeting either of them, but I suppose I'm going to have to meet one of them.
Well, whatever you do, you're out there in the final of the world. That's got to be a great feeling.
Unbelievable.
Well, now, after a couple of shandies, he knows he's in against Steve Davis, who, as you've seen tonight, played some of his most impressive snooker to knock out Cliff Thorburn. Steve Davis, you said before this match started that it could be war. It looked pretty hard.
Yeah, it was. There were times in the game that I think both of us would have rather been somewhere else. Yeah. And there were times when it was great fun and entertainment as well, because there was some tough stuff out there. And I was just pleased to get stronger in the end. That was good for me. I was very pleased at that.
You look very much like you were really enjoying it. I mean, there were a few smiles, even in the tense, tight moments out there.
Well, there were some sort of funny things happen, and there's sometimes when you nearly get a snooker and you don't quite make it. Sometimes like that, you know, you're all very keyed up, but sometimes towards the end of a frame, if something funny happens, you know, you don't mind that, but I generally always like to keep it fairly straight. But
that's the change, I think, in the way you approach snooker these days, because a few years ago you wouldn't have smiled and played like that, or you certainly weren't back in, was it 1981 in the semi-final when he had you grinding away?
Well, I usually sort of do any facial expressions when I'm walking back to the chair, and then by the time I've turned round, I've sort of forgotten that moment. I'm sitting down waiting for the next shot. But I'm probably more confident in myself now. Probably not to worry about letting my face slip every now and again. But in general, I like to sort of try and be in control of myself, because it's a tough game controlling the balls, and you have to be in control of yourself.
Where are you beginning to think of it as a final?
Well, obviously, a lot of people said that around me, but I knew that whoever got in the final would be stand a good chance, obviously. But no, because there's lots of things that have happened before in the past where I thought I've got through and have done enough. and have come unstuck. So I'm not as elated as if I'd won a final tonight. I'm got two more days to go as far as I'm concerned.
Exactly, because, I mean, is it going to be difficult even for you to build back up again now? It's a tremendous achievement because Cliff Thorburn's played so well this season. Mm. He played so well there. To build back up for another 2 days, here we go again.
Well, about 11-all, 12-all, I thought it wasn't. I didn't think I could do it if I won. But now it's finished, I'm sort of over that and I feel OK now.
But, and I say but, because you've got to play Joe Johnson. Now, this fella's come here, he's like he's on a merry-go-round at a fairground. He's having the time of his life. I mean, he's got nothing to lose whatsoever, has he?
No, well, I've been in situations like that as well. I've actually been in situations where I've had nothing to lose as well. I know what it feels like. And I won't be taking Joe lightly, and I'm sure that he won't be taking me lightly. He'll be trying his heart out.
You've never really played him, have you?
No, we haven't played in matches, really. We've played a few exhibitions. I've always known how good he's been, and I think everybody in snooker knew that. But he'd never, up until now, done it when it mattered. But now he has, and he's played phenomenal to win and come back against Terry, proved that he's got everything that's required, and a good performance against Tony Knowles to get through. Mm.
Well, I think it's going to be a final of contrast. Well done tonight, and we look forward to the next couple of days.
Cheers.
The final, then, over the next 2 days, and it all begins for us and for you on here on BBC Two, and it starts in Sunday Grandstand. That programme begins tomorrow at 1:55. 2 days of snooker between Steve Davis and Joe Johnson. Well, just seven men have won the world title here at the Crucible Theatre in 9 years, and they are the famous faces of snooker. And those 9 years here have certainly given us, and I hope you, some wonderful snooker and some wonderful memories, some still very clear.
He's done it. Dennis Taylor, for the first time, becomes Embassy World Snooker Champion.
Standing on the outside, looking in, you know. It's been a long time, don't know where to begin. So much I wanna say, so much I wanna do. Friends are telling me it's time that you broke through. I've been through the hard times of searching souls. You know, it's been a hard and roll. Now I feel a need in me, so hard to explain. Now I see the joy and light, and I wanna remain. Standing on the inside, I finally broke that line. Ring around the circle, don't you know that it feels so fine.
Away them blues.